Hello and welcome to the Occupational English Test, also known as OET. This is the writing subtest for physiotherapists. You will be given 40 minutes of writing time. Prior to that, you will be given 5 minutes of reading time. Your word limit ranges from 180 to 200 words. This letter has to be written on the basis of patient's case notes, which will be provided. The total marks is 500 and the grades range from A to E. The topics given are specific to the profession, meaning depending on your profession, your letter will also be of the same type. The criteria and scoring are as follows. The total marks amount to 38. Out of this, you've got 6 major categories and they are: number 1, purpose. You have been allotted 3 marks for purpose. This basically is about what you're writing and how accurately you understand the task given to you. The next one is clarity and conciseness, for which 7 marks are allotted. Here you have to present your ideas and all of the points mentioned in the case notes. Next comes organization and layout, for which you are again given 7 marks. This is how you write the structure of the letter and how you present it. The next is content, for which again you are allotted 7 marks. This basically tests your ability to write necessary information and relevant information. Genre and style is also allotted 7 marks. This basically sees the tone in which you're writing, whether you are using medical jargon while writing to a medical professional or whether you're writing simple language. Basically, your writing should be presented in a way that it reflects the task. Finally, language, which is again allotted 7 marks. This includes grammar, spelling, vocabulary, also capitalization and punctuation. Now, there are 3 types of letters basically. A referral letter. This is written when a patient is sent to another healthcare facility for a different kind of investigation or treatment. Then you have your transfer letter, which is written when a patient is sent to another healthcare facility or department to continue his or her treatment. And discharge letter is written when the patient is leaving your healthcare facility or clinic and will be going home. Before beginning the letter, you must ask yourself these questions. Who is the person I am writing to? What is the condition? Who is the patient? What type of letter is it? Will the reader gauge the situation? Are your requests obvious to find? Are there any other details? Are you following the structure? The best way to do this task is to follow certain strategies. To begin with, you must read the task carefully. This is to be done in order to familiarize yourself with the information. Once you do that, identify the type of letter, identify whom you're writing to, start with who you are in relation to the patient. Make sure you spend 30 seconds looking at the writing task. Relevance is extremely important. There are a lot of things that might be written in your or given in the case notes that might not be relevant. So you have to scan the case notes actively. Follow the power method, which basically means to plan, organize, write, edit, and review. Identify keywords, phrases, and information. Use the note form while making notes. Complete your letter at least 5 minutes earlier and use the 5 minutes to review and edit your letter. When writing, ensure that you use a formal tone. Do not use casual language or phrases. If you're writing to somebody in the medical field, then use medical terminology, but only where relevant. Avoid medical terminology for the layman. Think about your response very carefully. When writing the letter, write in complete sentences and do not use the note form. Now here is a sample structure of the letter. You can refer to this for your practice. This is only one type of letter. So the basic idea here that you have to focus on is the structure. As you can see, at the beginning you have your address, the date, the salutation, and the reference to the patient. You begin with stating the purpose here. Then mention the medical history, social background. Talk about the current condition. Ensure that you mention what type of letter this is or what type or plan is mentioned, it could be discharge, referral, or transfer. Put the conclusion. Put your signature line. Leave a space and put your designation. If your name is given, then do mention your name below the designation. Now let's move on to the next bit. Here is a description of the question and task. You will be given the task details. They could be in the following format. Using the information in the case notes, write a letter of referral to the endodontist, Dr. Patrick O'Malley, 17 Longview Road, Newtown. The patient's case notes and full medical history will also be mentioned in the case notes. So these are the parts of the letter. The first part, which consists of the address, date, salutation, reference. The middle part, which consists of introduction, medical history, social background, etc. The introduction will also consist of the purpose of the letter. And conclusion, where further relevant information is given. The last part is the signature line or signing off. When writing the letter, remember the first part, which is who you are writing to and their address. Next, include the date. If there is an appropriate date cited in the case notes, use only that date. If it is not mentioned, use the current date. This should be followed by dear and the recipient's last name. Include the patient's name and date of birth. For example, Ari John Smith, date of birth, mention the date of birth, or Mary Jones, comma, aged 7 years. Use correct punctuation while putting in these details. The middle part consists of the purpose of the letter to begin with. Here, this is present in the writing task. The purpose of the letter could be mentioned in two ways. Either it is mentioned at the end of the case notes. This also often tells you about the type of letter and the letter's main topic. Here is an example. Using the information in the case notes, write a letter back to the referring GP detailing your findings and suggesting a treatment plan. Address your letter to Dr. Evans, Yorktown Clinic, 24 Station Road, Yorktown, and dated 20th May 2020. So you've been given your address as well as the date. Here are some sample introductory lines that you can use while stating the purpose. The introductory sentence should be mentioned and should contain good words and phrases. For example, Ms. Joan has been a patient of mine for the past 5 years and needs further treatment. You could also write it in the other way. This is to thank you for accepting Mr. John into your care for the treatment. Sample introductory lines. The introductory sentence should always be mentioned. It should also contain good words and phrases. Two examples have been given here. The first one is, Ms. Joan has been a patient of mine for the past 5 years and needs further treatment. The second example is, this is to thank you for accepting Mr. John into your care for the treatment of his gums. In the middle part, you will of course have to expand the purpose. So expand the reasons given, give details about the patient's condition. When doing so, use complex sentences, not just simple sentences. An example has been done for you. I am referring Mr. John for further management and regular care of his tooth as he is conscious about his appearance. There could be more details which can be covered in the last paragraph. These details could include patient interaction and specific activities. They will also include medication, treatment, etc. The end part contains further relevant information and the conclusion. Usually the last two paragraphs are covered here. They include patient's medical history, current medication, general progress, etc. The final paragraph should include information like booking appointment, further monitoring like diet or blood sugar levels. You must end your letter with the lines, please do not hesitate to contact me if you have any questions. The signing off should include yours sincerely with a line space followed by your profession. If your name is given, include your name below the profession. The key to doing well in writing is using good grammar, understanding the structure, and putting important words or relevant words. Now, here are some important words which you could use or which you could remember while doing the task. Similarly, there are more words. This is a second set of words. The best thing for you to do would be to write down or practice sentences with these words. Here are some more common vocabulary related to physiotherapy. As you can see, some of the words are abdominal exercises, abdominal, sacral, massage, Achilles, tendinopathy, ACJ, acromioclavicular joint, which basically translates into the word sprain. Similarly, you have expressions such as deep tissue release, diastasis, recti fecal incontinence, gynae physio, hamstring tear. Practice writing sentences with these words. Some common mistakes that candidates often make are as follows. Writing grammatically incomplete sentences. For example, he told to check up instead of writing, he was told to get a checkup done. Or missing out on the pronouns. For example, fracture on left lower thigh. It could mean fracture on his or her left lower thigh. You have to indicate who the subject is. Third, using the wrong tenses. For example, he have a hip replacement when he was 30 years old. So you are obviously referring to the past, or writing a sentence like he needing regular blood pressure checks without mentioning the verb. The correct sentences are, he had a hip replacement when he was 30 years old, or he needs or will need regular blood pressure checks. This is your practice test 1. As you can see, you've been given the reading time as well as the writing time, and following which you will have the notes. They contain things like patient details, family patient history. This is the second part of the same case notes. Make sure you read thoroughly. This is the next part of the practice where you have physical examination findings and the treatment plan. The writing task is always given at the end, but it is suggested that you read the writing task first, because this will tell you what type of task it is or what type of letter it is, while also giving you the details of the address, dates, name of the person, and sometimes your name as well. Make sure to write approximately 180 to 200 words and do not use the note form. That is the end of this training video. All the best with your practice.